So we saw in our last classes that is our algebra lessons, that is linear equation in one variable. Okay. Now in this class let us see the new chapter, algebraic expressions and its identities. Okay. So before this we have one chapter, that is quadrilaterals. Is it right, children? Okay. See quadrilaterals lesson. Let us see later on. Okay. After this completion of this chapter. So why? Because this is continuation of the algebra chapter, that is linear equations in one variable. Okay, it is easy to understand now. So let us go on very fastly. Okay. So first, can you say what is algebraic expression? Recall the definition of algebraic expression. Okay. So what is the definition of algebraic expression? Any mathematical operations we can do. Okay, using of expressions. Okay, which consists of numbers, variables. Okay, these we can say it is a algebraic expressions. Okay, so let us see the parts of the algebraic expression. Okay, so algebraic expression. What is algebraic expression?
Multiplied by a factors.
each and every term was multiplied by a factors. Okay, so here 2. So we can take 2 means here also there is a factor. So 2 into 1 we can say 2. Okay, so what are the factors here? 1 and 2 are the factors here. Okay, as I say, 7n is a term. So here what are the factors of 7n? 7 is also a factor and n is also a factor. So 7n is the factor of the 7 and n are the factors of the term 7n. Okay, so then we move on to coefficient. Coefficient. So what does mean by coefficient? Okay, so a numerical value multiplied by the variable in a term, in a term of an algebraic expression. Okay, so in that the numerical value, the numerical numbers, okay, the numbers which is comes before the variables, okay, that we can say it is a coefficient of the variable. Coefficient of the variables in constants, okay, without variable terms we don't have coefficients. Okay, so the variable terms in a term the numerical values comes before the variable, that we can say it is a coefficient of the variable of a term. Okay, so here what is the coefficient of n? The coefficient of n is 7. The coefficient of n is 7. Okay, then we move on to the under one, variable. Okay, variable. What does mean by variable? What is variable? Values, that is variables, the alphabets we are using in an expression. This is in an algebraic expression. The variables, the alphabets which are we are using in an algebraic expression, that we can say it is a variable. So if it can be x, y, okay, x, y, or a, b, c, any alphabets we are using in an algebraic expression, okay, in the terms, so we can say that is a variables. Okay, we don't know the value of that variable. We are assumption in the algebraic. We are making assumption in the algebraic expressions. Understood, children? Okay. So any alphabets we are using it as a variable in an algebraic expression. Okay. So this we can say it is a variable. So here we took, which is the variable in 7n plus 2, n is the variable. Okay. Then operation. So what does mean by the term operation? So addition and subtraction. Addition and subtraction divides the term. Addition and subtraction divides the terms. Okay. That we can say it is a operations. Okay. So addition and subtraction divide, separates the terms in an algebraic expression. So that we can say. So addition and subtraction signs does the operations in an algebraic expression. That we can say here it is the sign of addition and subtraction is operations. Okay. Then constant. Constant. So what is the constant? It is very easy. Without any variable, the numerical value comes in an algebraic expression means that we can say it is a constant. Okay. So without any variables comes the numerical value in an algebraic expression means that we can say it is a constant. Understood now? So what are the terms we saw here? Term. So what is the terms? The terms are divided by the operation in an algebraic expressions. Okay. So that is every term is formed by the product of the factors. What is mean the factor? Every term is multiplied by the product of the factors. And then coefficient. Okay. So in the variable, okay, in an algebraic expression, the numerical value comes before the variable, that we can say it is a coefficient. Then variable. So any alphabets we are using in an algebraic expression, that we can say it is a variable. Then operations. Okay, addition and subtraction signs separates the terms in an algebraic expression. So that we can say it is an operation. And then constant. Without variable, of the algebraic expression. Okay, then let us see the next topic, that is how to represent the algebraic expression in number land. Okay, how to represent the algebraic expression in number land. So let us take a simple example, x plus 5. Okay, so this is an algebraic expression. So x plus 5, here we have a two terms. What are the two terms? X is one term and 5 is another term. Okay, so x plus 5 is an algebraic expression. Okay, so in this we have a variable and we have a coefficient. So here we have one is understood. Okay, and then we have a constant and operation. So all the parts of the algebraic expression is there in this algebraic expression. Okay, so how to represent this algebraic expression in number line? Okay, so let us draw a line. You all know how to draw a number line. You learned in your 7th standard class, is it right? Okay, now let us take 0 here. Okay, so we have the value of x first. Okay, so here we can take, this is x. Okay, and plus 5. Okay, plus 5. So like this we can represent. Okay, see R, okay, this is the same. Okay, so this is the method we are representing in a number line. Okay, so x plus 5. So this is the value x and this is the value 5. So we can represent like this, x plus 5. So this is x units and this is 5 units. Okay, so and one more thing you should keep it in your mind, when we are taking the additional form of algebraic expression x plus 5. Okay, so here we can represent the number line in the right direction. Okay, right side of the number line. Okay, that is from 0 to additional side, that is in the right direction. Okay, and as the same, if we have take 4x plus 5, okay, 4x plus 5 means here we want to change this. Okay, so we should mention this in a x, 4x here, 1x and 2x and 3x, and the number line should be extended. Okay, so 1x, 2x, 3x and 4x. See, 1x, 2x, 3x, 4x, and then we add the 5 units here, and then we add the 5 units here. Okay, so like this we can represent the number line. Okay, so it is for your understanding. Okay, and then let us take the subtraction sign. Okay, so we have the algebraic expression like this, x minus 5. So subtraction, okay, it moves to the left of the left in the number line. Okay, see here we can take 0 here. Okay, from here you can take x. Okay, so this is x. And minus 5. Okay, x minus 5. So again, you can minus it from this. It moves on left side. So this is 5 units. Okay, x minus 5. Okay, that is in number line. So the value of x minus 5 will be 5 units to the left of the x. So in addition, we added to the right of the x. Okay, and here the 5 units will be moves left of the x. So right of the x means the addition number line. Here the left of the x means it is a subtracted number line. Okay, so then we move on to the another topic, monomials, binomials and trinomials and polynomials. Okay, so in a, you know, we can see is based on the algebraic expression. Okay, so what are the topic we saw? That is monomials, binomials, trinomials and polynomials. So let us take an example by an algebraic expression. Okay, so what is the example we can take here? 5x square plus 2y plus 9xy plus 4. Okay, let us take this an example for algebraic expression. So, to learn about the topics monomials, binomials, trinomials, and polynomials. Okay, let us take this one term, that is 5x square. We can say it is a monomial. Okay, in this we can say the one term we can have is that we can say it is a monomial. Monomial. Okay, and another one we can take these two terms. 5x square plus 2y. We can have two terms. Okay, that we can say it is a binomial. Binomial. Okay, and then we can take three terms. Okay, three terms means we can say it is a trinomial. Trinomial. Okay, so one or more terms we can say it is a polynomial. Okay, see, only one term means it is a monomial. What is meant by monomial? An algebraic expression consists of only one term, that we can say it is a monomial. An algebraic expression is having two terms, that we can have binomial. So an algebraic expression having three terms, that we can say it is a trinomial. So examples, see, monomial means only one term. Monomial, see, 5x square. So only one term means we can say monomial. So 5x square plus 2y. Okay, so this is a binomial. And we can say 5x square plus 2y plus 9xy. So this we can say it is a trinomial. So one or more terms means that we can say it is a polynomial. Okay, so in